Josh got on well with Gran, especially once that second glass of sherry caught on, and we talked about Monk Park, about the house and the grounds, and the way Christmas had been celebrated in the old days. Gran managed to make 1950 sound like the 15th century, but she remembered so much about how things used to be done and the way the house used to be that it was quite entertaining. However, things caught up with her shortly after lunch, and she retired to her chair to think, whereupon Josh and I went to hide in the kitchen. Once alone, he seemed to suffer from a recurrence of the nervousness. He helped me stack plates but kept letting cutlery slip between his fingers until the kitchen rug was covered in splashes of old gravy. "Are you okay? I can open the back door if you want, although I warn you that Gran has a whole host of epithets to apply to people who leave their back doors open. I think it's a symptom of sluttish behaviour," I said, feeling the irony creeping into my voice. "Although chance would be a fine thing." Is that Julia?" It felt to me as though he seized on the sight of Jules, arm in arm with Simon the bank manager, walking through the snow across the field that backed the village. "And is that... has she got a dog?" "Never saw Julia as a dog person. Maybe a Rottweiler or something." "Oh, that's Simon's Labrador. Simon's spending Christmas with her family. Well, the bits of Christmas that are legal... Her brothers have got quite a robust approach to nobody wanted it so we took it, but I don't think she's told him that yet." Josh kept his eyes on the couple. I had to admit that Julia looked happy. They were practically a Christmas card illustration. Two young people, or people with a skilled hand with a makeup brush in Julia's case, kicking through an ankle-deep application of snow, preceded by an overexcited black dog with half a tree in its mouth. The bitterness stung the back of my mouth for a second.